First official night of our Time Check Jazz Festival, where we're featuring the alumni and the music of Buddy Rich throughout the entire weekend. Tonight we've got a reunion band that we've put together that features almost all members of the band tonight were in the Buddy Rich band at various times. Matter of fact, we'll start out and introduce the band to you. On piano is Christian Jacob. On guitar, Barry Zweig. Back there on bass is Rick Shaw. And on drums tonight is Bernie Dressel. Our saxophone section, Keith Bishop, Charles Owens, Tim Richmond, Richie Cole, and Pat LaBarbera. The trombones, Rich Bullock, Alan Kaplan, and Scott Whitfield. And the trumpet section, Mike Price, Pete Olstad, Chuck Findley, and Bobby Shue, the Buddy Rich Reunion Band.
Thank you. good night. It's nice to be doing all this Buddy Rich stuff. In my particular life as a player, I think it's probably one of the highest points that I ever had as a kid growing up, getting the opportunity to play with Buddy. Great learning experience, I can tell you. And a lot of the guys here tonight were on that band at one time or another. That particular thing we played is Big Swing Face, written by Bill Potts. And Bill had a nice big band in the Washington, D.C. area for a lot of years. And when the band was actually started, I don't know, you know, Ken has probably told you an awful lot about the band, but when it first started in spring of 1966, they put the band together and everybody was excited. And all the guys and everybody came in to hear. Sonny Payne all came to the rehearsals and all people like that. It's crazy. And I wasn't on the band at that point. It was a whole completely different band, but I was into photography, so I brought my camera, and I have about 150 photographs of that first band. And I'm going to dig them out one of these days and get a lot of people in trouble, probably. Anyway, it was an interesting thing. So they were booked to play at the Aladdin Hotel in Las Vegas for a two-week period, and they were working opposite Professor Irwin Corey. Really. And so when Professor Irwin Corey came on, the place was packed. And then when Buddy's band came on, everybody left. And Buddy had an extra drummer by the name of Bobby Morris, who was, he lived in Vegas and he owned what would you call it? It was a shop. He sold wigs for guys that were going bald and stuff. A carpet shop, I guess, you know, maybe. Origins of Carpeteria, maybe. But anyway, and Bobby was a pretty good drummer, and so Buddy had Bobby play drums on some tunes, and Buddy came out, sang, and tap danced, and so forth. And it was very interesting, and they had a girl singer by the name of Bobby Norris, and it was pretty good, but nobody was there. I mean, they played for 2 weeks, and it was an empty room almost all the time. And so they folded up the band, and that was the end of it. And then Buddy's whole problem with the IRS was so deep that he had to put the band back together and try to earn some money. So they reorganized the band, and that's when I came on. And it was very interesting to watch Buddy. You know, I'd seen him and played with him a couple of times that I subbed on Harry James' band. But, you know, Buddy was not the kind of guy you went up to and shook hands and put your arms around him and hugged him and stuff like that. You just kind of kept the distance. There was this vibe that was there. I'm sure you heard about the vibe. And so anyway, very interesting to see the beginning of the band. And so we put the band back together. And our first gig was Jack London Square in Oakland, California, a place called Casuals on the Square. And we went out there for a week. They put us on buses, and some people drove out there and so forth. We played a week, and it was packed every night to the hilt. And, I mean, everybody was in the place. You couldn't even get in the door. And they held us over for an extra week. So we did like 2 weeks at this club, and it was insane, you know. And Herb Wong was there and writing up reviews of the band and the whole thing. And suddenly the band took off. We came back to Vegas, and we did a week at the Sands Lounge, and then we did another week with Buddy Greco, and who incidentally wrote You Rotten Kid for Buddy. And he was. Buddy Greco wrote for Buddy Rich, anyway. Anyway, it was a great time. The band was taken off, and then we went to the Shea in L.A., and we recorded the Swingin' New Band album. And prior to that, we also did, if you haven't heard it, one of the greatest albums was the Sammy Davis and Buddy Rich live album at the Sands, which we did about 4 o'clock in the morning. And that was a ridiculous album. That band was so good. Anyway, it was great. And it's fun for me to look back and remember some of those days, you know, how good that band was. And we could tell you the personnel on the band, but it was just like who's who. You know, Gene Quill on lead alto, and Marty Flax and Jay Corey, and Steve Perlow, and holy cow, and John Bunch on piano, and it was ridiculous. And So anyway, to get on with this thing, a lot of the stuff that we're doing tonight is from that particular era. One of the when the book was first started, one of the people that had contributed a number of charts was Oliver Nelson. And he had just taken some charts out of his own recordings and out of his own book and given them to Buddy. And Oliver wrote a lot of stuff for the band, some of which we never played much of, but some did we did. So the next one we're going to do right now is one of Oliver's contributions to the book, and it's one of Duke's tunes. This is In a Mellow Tone.
Thank you.
This next chart we're going to do for you is also by Oliver Nelson, and this is a very important chart for me because I won't say any names here, but when the band was formed, that first day of that first rehearsal, Buddy, we played about three tunes, and then Buddy got angry and stood up and threw the drumsticks down and said, "Why can't I get a lead trumpet player?" And I won't tell you who that was. You'd know him, but it wasn't me. But anyway, so Steve Furlow, who was the baritone player and the band manager at that point, said, "Why don't you try Bobby on lead?" And I'm going, "Shut up." Because I wasn't really like a lead player. You know, I was always played like the jazz chair on most of the bands, all the way back through the military and everything. And I'd play an occasional chart on a lead thing, but it was no big deal. And so Buddy says, "Shoot, get on that chair." So I'm like, "Oh, God, here I go," you know. So I moved over there, and they called up this chart. Luckily, it wasn't too hard. And it was just right up my alley, sort of. So I played it, and then Buddy said, we played the one chart. And he said, "All right, you're the lead player." And I said, "Buddy, I don't have the chops to be a lead player." He says, "I don't want to hear any of your crybaby shit. You get your chops together. You tell me here tomorrow you're the lead player. You got it?" So I went home and looked for another mouthpiece. That's the only thing I knew. I didn't know how to play lead. I said, "Just get a mouthpiece that plays high notes, quick." So that was how it all started. So this chart we're going to do now is Oliver Nelson's chart. It's called Step Right Up. Thank you. Thank you. So while we were at in Oakland, California, doing the casuals on the square for 2 weeks, a guy came in who had a big band locally and used to play at this place called the Golden Nugget, which was one of the better jazz clubs in the Oakland area at that particular time. And his name was Don Pystrup, and he had his own big band up there. And so he brought some charts in, and he wanted to present them to Buddy and kind of see if he was interested in them. And the one we're going to play for you right now is the first chart he brought in to us, which we actually recorded, and Buddy liked it right off the bat. So it features Chuck Finley, and I'm not sure, I can't remember who else. Somebody else plays. You'll know, you'll recognize him. Oh, it's Pat, yeah, of course. Okay, well, this is Don Pystrup's composition. It's called Group Shot.
Thank you.
Nice. Nice chart, huh? Nice. Very unusual. So when we got this gig at the Shea on Santa Monica Boulevard, a lot of guys came in, writers came in and presented their music for the book. Because when by the time we got to the Shea, we only had 39 charts in the book, and that was not very many. And a lot of them Buddy didn't care for, and so he started weeding things out. But we were having a rehearsal one day in the afternoon at the club, and in walks the great Bill Holman, and brought this chart. And this was the first contribution of the great many that Bill contributed to the book over the years. And this was also recorded on that Swingin' New Band album with West Side Story and all that stuff. So we hope you enjoy Bill's composition, Ready Mix. Thank you. Roma does not know how to write a bad chart, I can assure you. Even if he tried, he couldn't do it. So we're going to present a couple of things now by another writer. And this guy was, he and I were in the military band together with Barry Zweig, was in that same band. And a lot of guys here in town, called the NORAD band, stationed in Colorado Springs. And we had an amazing trombone player in that band by the name of Phil Wilson. And this chart that we're going to do now was written actually for the NORAD band. It was written during that period of time. And then Phil just brought it in to Buddy, and so Buddy liked it, and it got in Buddy's book, and it got in Louis Belson's book, and it got in pretty much everybody else's book over the years. And Phil, if you don't know, he's still a current faculty at Berklee School of Music in Boston, and he must have been there for like 75 years teaching at that school, God. But anyway, he's a great writer and a great trombone player, and a mainstay of the Woody Herman Band for so many years, and really unique. So here's Phil Wilson's chart, and this is called Basically Blues. Thank you. Yeah, how about these guys? You know, we rehearsed this whole thing today in just about an hour, or a little more than an hour. We actually didn't play all these charts. We just kind of started them, and we played about 8 bars, and we stopped and went to the next one. Because these guys know this stuff. We could have sight-read this concert tonight, I think, you know. We're going to do another one by Phil Wilson. This is a classic tune written by Joe Zawinul that was recorded by the Cannonball Adderley Quintet. Very popular tune, and a nice chart. Buddy was very fond of this one, played it a lot. This is Mercy, Mercy, Mercy.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah. How about Bernie Dressel, huh? How about that? So, about this same time when the band was playing at the Shea, we came back there and played a second time in early 67. And in comes another, a bunch of writers came in at that time also and brought charts in. And so the one we're going to play next for you is by the great trombone player Harry Betts, who spent a lot of years writing an awful lot of music for the films and television stuff here in Los Angeles studios. And this was recorded on the Big Swing Face album as well. This is Harry's composition. It's called Mexicali Nose. Exciting chart, huh? Yeah. Yeah, Bernie. Buddy would have been proud, man. So, this next chart is by a trumpet player you all know well. He's been here a jillion times at these events. And he was my roommate on a Woody Herman band and on, geez, almost every band I ended up on. I ended up rooming with this guy. I don't know why. Somebody had to keep an eye on him. His name was Don Rader. And this is a chart that he wrote for Buddy's band. We'd like to do for you now. And this is Chicago.
Thank you.
Bernie Dressel. Holy patootie. Bernie, you can stay. You can stay, man. That's pretty good, I would say.
Oh, man. Unbelievable.
Now, Bernie, I'd like you to play a ballad, but I want you to take the melody. We'd like to do one more for you, and as I said, when we played at the Shea the second time, a lot of writers came in, and this guy was a trombone player from Manchester, England, who he and I used to tour together with Della Reese back in before Buddy's band was formed, and his name's Pete Myers. He's here this week, so you'll get to hear his big band and so forth. And this chart is probably one of the most famous ones that Buddy's band ever recorded. Every place you go in the world, every band has this in the book, and it's one of the best. It's Pete Myers' arrangement of Love for Sale.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much. How about a hand for this wonderful band?
Once again, the all-star Buddy Rich Reunion Band. Buddy Dressel on drums. Barry Zweig, guitar. Christian Jacob on piano. Rick Shaw on bass. The trumpet section again, Mike Price, Pete Olstad, Chuck Findlay, and Bobby Shue. The trombones, Rich Bullock, Alan Kaplan, Scott Whitfield. And the saxophone section, Keith Bishop, Charles Owen, Richmond, Richie Cole, and Pat LaBarbera.
Go home, go home, go to your rooms.
There'll be more like that tomorrow. Thank you all very much. We'll see you tomorrow. Have a great evening. And tomorrow morning we've got another film showing and lots of great concerts. So we'll see you then. Thank you.